First Corinthians chapter 10, verse 13. There have no temptation taken you, but such as common as is common to man. But God is faithful, who will not suffer you to be tempted above that ye are able, but will with the temptation also make a way to escape, that ye may be able to bear it. Father, we are grateful, thankful for your divine power and presence that is here today. I plead the blood of Jesus. There's power in the name of Jesus. We call upon you. We call upon that name that is above every name. And I plead the blood of Jesus, God, arrest minds, deal with hearts, bring deliverance, God. Pour out your spirit, God. Fill someone with the Holy Ghost, God. Let someone answer the call to repent and to be baptized in the name of Jesus. And we give you glory. We give you honor. In Jesus' name, you may be seated. What powerful words we read this morning from the Apostle Paul to the church of Corinth. And I want to take a thought that I really feel impressed of the Lord to speak to you from this morning, from this verse of Scripture. My subject today is this: there is a way of escape from every temptation. There is a way of escape from every temptation. God is really trying to help some people today to escape from the temptations that you often find yourself trapped in. You're in a prison because you keep giving in to that temptation. God wants to set some people free today, because he who the Son has set free is free indeed. There is a way. Some of you feel like there is no way, so I might as well keep doing what I'm doing. No, there is a way. There is a way of escape, that you don't have to be trapped into that temptation. Have you ever noticed that the more you focus on a problem, the bigger and more intense it seems to become in your mind? In fact, if you, somebody say me, if you don't get a grip on your mind, you don't get a grip on your emotions in these situations, your mind will try to blow that problem far out of proportion. And even if you're facing a real crisis, you have the power to get your mind under control. See, some people keep giving in to temptations because they've not gotten their mind under control. But you can get your mind under control through the power of the Holy Ghost. Thank God for the Holy Ghost. See, some people keep falling into the temptation or being trapped in the temptation because they don't have no power to overcome the temptation. But when the Bible says you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you. And when you receive the Holy Ghost, you're not just receiving a good feeling, you are receiving dunamis, supernatural power to overcome any trial, any test, and any temptation that comes your way. But once you receive this power, you got to maintain that power. You got to walk in that power. Amen. You just can't receive the Holy Ghost and stop coming to church. Amen. You just can't receive the Holy Ghost and stop reading your Bible. You have to feed that spiritual man. You have to feed that spiritual woman. You can't keep going back to the same things that were trapping you. Amen. 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 You got to get control over your mind. That's one reason why people keep falling into temptation. They have no control over their mind. However, if you let your emotions have their way, see, a lot of people just let their emotions have their way. But what happens is that the situation will arise to the point that those things will play over and over and over and over in your mind until it finally manifests as a reality in your life. And I know in these uncertain times, we are living in uncertain times. We're living in a crazy hour. Nothing surprises me now. Amen. I mean, people are facing all kinds of huge challenges that have left them feeling stuck in the situation that they're in. Many of people today, some of you might today be feeling, I don't feel like there's a way out. Now, when you're trying to do it on your own, there is no way out. When you keep allowing yourself to trust in the arm of flesh, the Bible says, put not your trust in the arm of flesh. See, if you keep trying to do it on your own, you're going to keep being in the same mess you're in right now. But when you get the Holy Ghost, when you get filled with the power of God, amen. I've had many temptations in my life. And I remember before I got saved, there was stuff I was doing I could not stop doing. I could not stop smoking, drinking, living in a sinful lifestyle. I couldn't stop drinking liquor. I couldn't stop smoking dope. I had to get high all the time. I tried to stop. I tried to get a New Year's resolution. I tried this, I tried that, I tried this, but it didn't work. Because I was trying to do it on my own. But I went to a meeting when my heart wasn't right and something got a hold of me. And what I'm talking about is the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost will give you the power to look temptation facing right in the face and say, yo, I'm not doing that. You can look temptation right in the eye. Say, I'm not going there no more. I'm not doing that no more. I'm not shacking up no more. I'm not going out on no date with you no more. I'm not calling your number no more. Amen. And the reason many people can't really get to that place, because, you know, people say they got the Holy Ghost, but they don't really have the Holy Ghost. And we got to really find out, do I have the Holy Ghost? And you don't know if you had the Holy Ghost, is what will happen is you'll speak in other tongues as the Spirit of God give you utterance. That's the first initial sign of being filled with the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
But it doesn't stop there.
No.
You don't go buy a brand new car and get a full tank of gas and think you're just going to drive for 20 years on one tank of gas.
That's good.
It don't work like that.
That's good.
It don't work like that. I wish it would. You can't even buy an electric car now. I think you're just going to get one charge and drive for, you know, from here to California. I'm going to charge it up and we going to California. You know, you're going to pull up somewhere and get a charge again. And see what's happening in people's lives, they're not getting a recharge, a refilling of the Holy Ghost. And they're running around on empty. And when temptation come in their face, they can't overcome it. They can't deal with it. They can't get no victory over it because they're powerless. Trapped in their mind. When you get the Holy Ghost, and I don't know why people are afraid of the Holy Ghost. Some people are afraid of the Holy Ghost. I don't want the Holy Ghost because I don't want to run like her. I don't want to shout like her. I don't want to do what they doing. You need to do what they doing. You need to praise God. Amen. Thank God for the power the Holy Ghost can do in a person's life. When I think about Daryl and Ariel, and I'm coming in this church, some of you don't know what he looked like when he came here. You don't have a clue what they look like. But the Holy Ghost, the Holy Ghost, cleaned them up, put a hunger for God in them. Amen. If the Holy Ghost will clean you up. It'll start telling you, get this out of your life, get that out of your life, throw this away. The Holy Ghost will start, it'll tell you to throw some stuff away. I said the Holy Ghost will tell you to throw some stuff away. Amen. But I'm here to tell you there's a way of escape out of every temptation. And I know some of you're dealing with some temptations that have a stronghold in your life. And God said, I want to break that stronghold. You are bound to this temptation. Pornography may be your temptation. Drugs may be your temptation. Amen. Fornication may be your temptation. Adultery may be your temptation. I don't care what the temptation is. Lying may be your temptation. Stealing may be your temptation. Cursing people out may be your temptation. I don't care what your temptation is. There's a way of escape. You can be set free. Amen. There's a way of escape. But you got to trust God. You got to do it His way. You can't do it your way. You got to do it His way. And you say, well, what is His way? You got to repent.
That's right. Yeah.
I said, you got to repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for remission of your sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
I mean, there's a way. Some of you facing some serious temptations right now. And the devil got it laid before you, laying it out before you every single day.
Right. Yes, sir.
Every day. Go do this. Go do that. But I'm telling you, the voice that you feed the most. If you feed your flesh the flesh gonna have the most loudest voice in your life. But if you feed the spirit man and the spirit woman, you'll be able to have victory over that temptation. I don't care what the struggle is. I don't care what you're going through. God can give you victory over that struggle. Amen. Amen. If you got prejudice in your heart, God can. If it's a temptation to hate people, be prejudiced towards certain people, God can take that out of you. He can make you love people you used to hate.
Amen.
That's what the Holy Ghost will do.
Amen.
The Holy Ghost will make you hug people you wouldn't even think
right,
of.
Right.
And I'm here to tell you, ain't no prejudice going into heaven.
That's right.
You can hate certain people of certain cultures and creeds and nationalities, but that stuff not going into heaven.
Amen.
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 You got to get it that down right. You got to get that right down here.
Amen.
You can't go up into heaven with hatred in your heart.
Amen.
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 I don't care what the temptation is.
Amen.
Amen. You can be violent, abusive. I just feel like hitting somebody all the time.
Yeah.
Well, sometimes you do feel like that. You may feel like that. Don't feel like that too long now. Because if you let that meditate in your mind long enough, amen, you would be at the wrong place at the wrong time, and somebody say something to you. Amen. There are many kinds of struggles we all face. People struggles. Somebody say people struggles. Anytime we have addictions and things of that nature, traps that we find ourselves in. I mean, there's all kind of abuse, illicit sex, pornography, and pornography is big time now.
Yeah. Right, right.
Amen. Yeah. Men don't need to be on pornography.
That's right. Right, right, right. Yes, sir.
Women don't need to be on. It ain't just men now.
Uh-huh.
Amen. You don't need to have no porn books in the house.
Yes, sir. Right.
You don't need to have no porn books, no porn videos.
Amen.
That's right. Amen. It's just the sports swimsuit edition. No, you don't need that in the house either. Amen. And if you know a certain thing is a temptation and a struggle,
right.
If you get saved and your temptation was drinking, you don't need to go to the bar.
That's right.
Hang
That's
out. Or well, the fellas going after work to the bar, get a few drinks.
That's good.
I don't drink no more. You don't need to go get no. You don't even need to be in that environment.
That's right. That's good.
Don't even need to be in that environment. If drinking is a temptation, you don't need to go to no bar atmosphere.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
You need to make up your mind. I'm not going there.
That's right.
Amen. If lust is a major problem, there's certain restaurants you don't need to go to.
Amen. Right. That's right.
You don't need to be going to Hooters.
Right.
That's right.
Like Disney got not getting none of my money, Hooters ain't getting none of my money.
Right.
I got to go to Hooters because of the wings. There are too many other places to get some wings than Hooters. Come on now. Wings stop. You be better off just going to get some wings from McDonald's, praise God. Just like they wings. No. Bless your problem. I ain't never been to Hooters, but I heard what Hooters waiters look like. You don't need to know. You going to Hooters and you were struggling with pole dancers. Then the waiter come, you think, oh man, no, help me, Holy Ghost.
Come on now, come on.
Right? That's good.
Hooters.
That's good.
For real Hooters. Hooters. What does it look like the child of God, a man of God, in Hooters? Where they going out to work? I don't. You need to tell them you need to tell them I ain't got no money. Tell them you ain't got no money. Tell them something. Don't go to no Hooters. I'm not going. You can tell them I don't need to go to Hooters. I got a fine wife at home I can go look at. Come on now. You be better off just go get some frozen wings from Food Lion, praise God. Throw them in the oven. Put some hot sauce on them. Barbecue sauce on them. And keep your mind straight. There's some place that ain't getting my money. Hooters not getting my money. Disney not getting my money.
Thank you, Lord.
You do what you want to do.
Thank you.
Amen. God trying to get you delivered from these temptations. I mean, some of our women struggling with the temptation to want to look like the world and dress like the world. And, you know, you ain't got to do all that.
That's right.
Just pray, God, help me with my insecurities. Help me understand that I am who I am because of who you created me to be.
That's right.
You ain't got to follow the world.
That's right.
Beyonce not your role model.
Right.
Women are tempted to want to be like Beyonce, look like Beyonce.
Right.
Want to look like Jay-Z. I'm not tempted to be like them, look like them.
Right.
Amen. I mean, we got to get a hunger for God, the ways of God, the things of God. Amen. Somebody say, I got to overcome this temptation. Amen. You got to overcome these temptations to get all angry and upset with people all the time.
Amen.
Amen. I'm talking about you got to deal with those unchecked emotions. That you deal with in relationships, whether past or present, that can cause all kind of emotional anguish and make your mind feel trapped in emotional pain. Amen. And you know, I've learned over the years that people can be a mystery. You know, I don't need no mystery book. You just work with people. People can be a mystery. You say, what do you mean by that? I'll tell you what I mean by that. I mean, when you finally think you have that person all figured out, and then they do something or say something that just totally lets you down or blows your mind. But I thought I had to figure it out. I never would have dreamed in a million years that they would do or say things they're doing right now. That's why you got to learn how to overcome the temptation and the trap to take offense. And get upset every time somebody disappoints you or lets you down. You can't fall into that trap every time somebody disappoints you to get upset. Amen. I'm trying to help somebody this morning. Because if you really want to enjoy life and walk in victory, get out of that prison in your mind. You got to learn to forgive. You got to learn to overlook people's inconsistencies. You got to learn to overlook their lack of commitment. You got to learn to overlook their unfaithfulness. You got to learn to overlook their temper tantrums. You got to learn to overlook their rage road driving. You got to overlook their mood swings. Amen. As well as all the other defects that's a part of the human being body. Can I tell y'all something? There ain't a person in here perfect.
That's right.
Sir. No, sir.
There, I know you think you're perfect. There ain't nobody here perfect. Can I be honest with you? There are days I don't even understand my own moods. I'll be longing for the day when I can walk in the spirit 100% of the time. Right. There ain't a soul up in here that walks in the spirit 100% of the time.
That's good. That's good.
I don't care how much word you have. Right. I don't care how much you pray.
Right.
I don't care how much spirituality you think you have.
Right.
There is nobody here under the sound of my voice from the pulpit to the pew that walked in the spirit 100% of the time.
Right.
Even Christians who pray hours, read the Bible.
Right.
Pray in the spirit. Seek a holy living lifestyle. Sometimes get in the flesh and say things and do things that they later regret. It's just human part. It's just the human being body. The part we're in is flesh. It's just a part of being human.
That's right.
It ain't just justified keep doing it now.
Right.
But when we one day receive them glorified bodies. All of our inconsistencies, our mood swings, our complex emotions will be gone. But until then, you got to stay in an attitude of forgiveness, and we need to extend mercy to others that we expect them to extend to us. Amen. We can't always get bent out of shape and lose our peace every time somebody says or does something below our expectation. Amen. You can't get upset and bothered, disappointed, dissatisfied,
right,
irritated, vexed, and frustrated. You'll live in a prison. And that's a temptation that many people fall in every day. Somebody just do something to disappoint them. I mean, they vexed, they upset, they angry. I said, you got to overcome that temptation.
Right.
Just overcome it. Amen. Rather than looking at everybody else's inconsistencies, why don't you just go look in the mirror?
Yeah.
Let the Spirit of God talk to you.
Right.
Let the Spirit of God tell you about you and what you need to change.
Yeah.
Amen. And what I've learned too is sometimes God will use them people that you think have done you wrong, that God really using them to expose weaknesses in us. He will use other people to reveal weaknesses in us that need to change.
Wow.
And we all upset with them, and we all angry and vexed and bitter with them. And God said, I'm just using them to work something out of you. I need to get out of you.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
And you think it's the enemy, but it's me sending them to use them to get this stuff out of you.
Amen.
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 We got to walk in the Spirit, church. We got to let the fruit of the Spirit be manifested in our life. If we're going to overcome these temptations. Amen. I mean, you can't be thinking the ill will of people all the time. Whatsoever things are just, pure, lovely, and of good report, if there be any virtue, be any praise, think on these things. Galatians 5:22 says, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Against such there is no law. And as Christians, are we Christians?
Amen.
As Christians, we need to learn how to let the fruit of the Spirit be manifested in our life regardless of the situation.
Amen.
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 You know, the real proof of spiritual maturity, I may say the real proof.
Real.
You know, when our relationships with other people are going great, when you have no challenges with people, no problems with people, no conflict with anyone, it's not hard nor difficult to be kind,
right,
loving,
right,
long-suffering,
right,
and easy to get along with,
right,
when everything going good in your relationships with people.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
Real proof of spiritual maturity, I'm going to tell you what the real proof is. It's not measured by the moments when our flesh is comfortable. It's revealed when you run into situations that rub your flesh the wrong way.
That's good.
That's the real spiritual maturity mark.
That's good.
When people rub you the wrong way.
Yes.
Are you tempted to to get bitter and angry with them? Are you tempted to just have ill feelings toward them? That's the see, for years I used to think the real spiritual maturity mark was how big somebody's Bible was. How long they prayed. Did they pray in tongues? But I've come to tell you, I've learned over the years, that's not the real true spiritual maturity mark. The real proof of spiritual maturity and growth is when somebody rub you the wrong way. That's maturity. Amen. So what if somebody you're dealing with offends you, hurts you? How do you respond? Some people have been abused in their life. Betrayed, deserted by a spouse, by a family member, stabbed in the back by a friend, church member, rejected, betrayed by parents. And those things can make you feel real upset. Like Minister Beebe said, there are days I'm just, he said, he literally said, I'm going to pull my hair out. Amen. Just keep living. Just keep living. But I'm going to share something with you, though, in this verse here. Notice it says, there have no temptation taken you, but such is common to man. But God is faithful, who will not suffer you to be tempted. Above that, you're able, but will with the temptation also make a way to escape, that you may be able to bear it. There's one little word I want to bring out here for a moment. It's this word escape. This word escape is a Greek word, ekbasis. This word ekbasis comes from two different words, ek, which means out, and basis, which means to go or to walk. But when compounded together, ek and basis, the new word identifies the ideal of an exit and literally means to walk out, as to walk out of a difficult place, to walk out of a trap, or to walk out of a place that isn't good for you. When I read that definition, I felt the Holy Ghost say, there's some things that some of you need to walk out of. There's some difficult places you've allowed yourself to be in. And God says, I want you to escape out of that. I want you to walk out of that place that you're in that's not good for you. There's some relationships that people get in that's not good for them. They need to walk out of it. Amen. You feel like doing some things that you know are not pleasing in the eyes of God. You need to walk out of that situation. You need to get full of the Holy Ghost. And I don't know who it is today, but if you don't have the Holy Ghost, you need to get full of the Holy Ghost. You need to get baptized in the Holy Ghost. Because I know we want to think we can overcome all these temptations on our own, but you cannot do it. You will not be able to do it. That fine guy come along and he pull up in that car and you ain't got your car yet. And you playing the right music. What's your name?
Who, me?
Yeah. Ain't nobody else around.
Who, me? Yeah, you. What's your name? Oh, my name's so-and-so. Where you going? I'm on my way to the mall. Can I give you a ride? Oh, yeah.
First of all, you shouldn't even be getting in no car.
Right.
With no stranger. Amen. And before you know it, you're in the car. And all of a sudden, you're going somewhere you ain't got no business going.
Yep.
Amen.
Amen.
I gotta stop by the house for a moment. You go by the house. Matter of fact, you wanna come in for a moment? No, I don't think so. Yeah, come on in for a moment. You go in the house for a moment. And you know the story.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
It can happen just like that.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
I'm talking about overcoming temptations. When your flesh saying, go on and do it. Go on and do it. You say, devil, no, I'm not going to do that. I'm not going back down in that path of that lifestyle I used to be in.
That's right.
You can't make me do that, devil.
That's right.
I mean, we're in an hour now of people being tempted. I mean, this is a crazy hour we're living in. And I know pulpits don't want to say it, and we got to be so politically correct, but I got to say it. I mean, we people being tempted with girls like girls.
Right.
Amen.
Right.
Amen.
Guys like
no.
This ain't of God.
No.
I just gotta say it. I know I ain't politically correct from society's point of view, but I gotta say it. It's in the Word.
Right.
And I've said this time before that, you know, the animal kingdom got more sense than human beings sometimes.
Right. Right.
Because I ain't never seen two squirrels,
right,
two male squirrels chasing one another.
Right. That's right.
Two male pit bulls chasing one another.
That's right. Good.
I normally see the male pit bull chasing the female pit bull.
Right.
But this is where we're living at now.
Yeah.
And some stuff society's saying is right is wrong.
Yeah.
And when people are being tempted to give into that nonsense, whether it's drugs, whether it's liquor, whether it's pornography, whether it's cursing and lying and stealing, you got to say, I'm not going to give in to that temptation. Man, we got people that used to be alcoholics in this congregation. We got people that used to think they were real pimps and players in this place tonight.
Jesus.
We got drug addicts,
yes,
dope dealers,
yes,
crackheads,
yes,
liquorheads,
yes,
cigarette smokers,
right,
adulterers,
yes,
fornicators.
Yeah.
Come on now, we got all kinds of people that were given into all kinds of temptation but have been delivered. I don't care if your mama did it, your grandma did it, your grandma did it, your granddaddy did it. It don't mean you have to do it. Amen. My wife is bringing out some powerful stuff in Sunday school about what she's seen growing up. Somebody would never have thought this beautiful lady would be who she is today coming out of the home she came out of. I mean, to grow up and your mama tell you it's okay for them to hit you. And some people have that mindset. That's how you help them get they mind straight. You gotta hit them a few times. No. And men, if you ever had the temptation to lay your hand on your wife or your girl, your fiance, some of these sisters say it'd be the last time you raise your hand. You might raise one up and only have one. Men don't hit women. Men don't hit women. She may, no. She just got you, and you just need to flee the temptation. Amen. We live in an abusive society.
Amen.
Then they get in these crazy relationships. The dominant man hitting the weaker man. We might as well make it plain. The dominant female soccer punching the weaker female. You already know who the male and who the female in the situation.
Right.
Oh no.
Right. That's right.
You don't tell the truth.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, you are.
Amen.
Amen.
We got to come out of some stuff. We can't keep giving in to the flesh. Amen. Now, see, there are three ways you're going to deal with temptation. One is you're going to try to deal with it on your own. I said, you're going to try to deal with it on your own. And you'll keep giving in. You'll keep falling. You'll keep making the same old mistake. And many people live like this. If it feel good, just do it. I can't stop it. Yes, you can stop
it. Right, that's right.
Amen.
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 It was, I just can't stop smoking drugs. There's enough men here that used to smoke drugs.
That's right. That's right.
They used to smoke drugs.
Right.
Used to smoke drugs.
Right.
Well, I feel like being a dope dealer. We got ex-dope dealers in the house. They can help you understand. You don't have to try to sling dope drugs and sell dope to make a living. Go get a job. Amen. Man don't work, he don't eat. Don't bite the temptation to just feel like you're going to sit at home and play video games all day. No. Sisters, if you find a guy, I don't care how handsome he look, if all he want to do is sit at home and play video games all day, and then want to ride around in your car all day, drive your gas money up all day, you need to say, listen, hit the road, Jack. Don't you come back no more, no more, no more. Hit the road, Jack. Amen.
Amen.
You want to ride around your gas while you at work. Then you come home and he playing video games, dishes all in the sink. What? Don't wash the clothes. What are you doing, nigga? Oh, I'm about to make it to the next level of the video game. You think it's funny, but this is how men live.
Right, that's true. Amen.
Amen. Man, you find a wife, you find a good thing. Amen. That don't mean you just sit at home and do nothing all day.
Right.
You don't want to watch as the world turns.
Oh, no.
I don't know how people sit at home and watch soap operas. Don't even get to that, the soap operas. Or she just want to watch Judge Mathis all day. I don't know why people watch that foolishness.
Right.
I don't even know why people go on TV with their drama like that.
Right.
Judge, I mean, come on now. My son went to school with one person one time. They were on Jerry Springer.
Oh,
Jerry B.
You wasting your time sitting up home watching. I don't even know if it's on anymore.
Oh, no.
Jerry Springer. What you been doing today, babe? Oh, I've been playing solitaire all day. I've been up on my Facebook all day. Spider webs all in the house. Trash ain't even taking. I'll wait on you, baby, to take it out. Let me tell you, when you get married, it's a joint effort.
That's right.
I clean the bathroom, my wife clean the bathroom.
That's right.
She do a good job and better job than I do, so I just, you know, she tell me sometimes, let me do this. But she do a better job than I do.
Right.
Now, when I get militant, though, praise God, when that military come out of me, I'm white glove everything. You know, down on the toilet, baseboard.
Amen.
Sister Mackie cleaning crew come and inspect. Praise God. I mean, you just, you know, people, you know, you gotta, I love something my wife used to say, you better explore, but don't ignore. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Somebody said, well, I got some good counseling on marriage today. Amen. Praise God. I ain't saying every day you gotta cook, but sometimes you gotta do something, praise God. I don't know how. Just get some ramen noodle, praise God.
That's it.
Go to, you know, YouTube and make you know how to spice ramen noodles up. Just throw the ramen noodle in the pot.
That's right.
Put some nice seasoning in it. Uh-huh. Turn the lights down when your husband come home.
Oh no.
I go to the candle shop. Nice candle on the table. Put that new robe on. Praise God. You ain't got to know how to cook, you know, 5-star meals. Run to the grocery store, buy a salad, throw it in a pot. It's for you. It's like the guy came home from fishing. He said, "Babe, look what I caught. I mean, had massive, had almost 50 fish. He said, "Babe, I caught all this today. Caught all these fish, caught all of them." She said, "Really?" He said, "Yeah, really, I caught all of them. 50 big, massive fish." He said, "I caught them today." She said, "Really?" She said, "You really tell the truth?" He said, "I did." She said, "No." He said, "I did." She said, "Where do you get them from?" He said, "I went to the grocery store and I told him to throw them, and when he threw them, I caught them. I caught every last one of them. I caught them all for you, baby." I said, "He said, throw them." And I caught them. I caught them all for you. That's what I caught for you, baby. Amen. I don't. I just get one of them instant things. Put it in my mouth. You cook wings, everything. Praise God. Brother Sister Marino turned us on one of them things, man. Praise God. Ooh, you cook some good stuff in one of them. What do you call it? Instant fryers? Air fryer. Oh, my God. You don't know how to cook. Just throw it in the air fryer. Some salt, pepper, something on it. Miss Dash.
Right.
Obey. That's the whole thing. And you save us some money. Even some of these new, my son said, "Thank you, Jesus. Praise God." Can't keep giving in all these temptations, though, my church. I mean, the temptation, you know what your temptation is.
Yes, sir. Right.
You don't have to give in and be trapped to that temptation.
Right.
Drugs, your temptation, I've come to tell you that you can be delivered from it.
Right, that's right.
Yes, sir. Oh, yeah.
You can leave this service totally liberated.
That's right.
Never having a desire to want to smoke another cigarette.
Right.
Somebody said, "Oh, I didn't know smoking was not good for me." Just read the label.
Right.
The label tell you it's not good for you.
Right.
Even the Bible says that your body belongs to God. It is the temple of the Holy Ghost. If any man defile the body, God will destroy. God will. Your body don't belong to you. You can't just do what you want to do with your body. If you feel that temptation, "Ooh, I want to go get tatted up." Now, if you came to Christ tatted up, that's one thing. It's under the blood. But after you get saved, get filled with the Holy Ghost, you shouldn't be tempted to go get no tattoo.
That's right. That's good.
It's
true.
I'm in the Bible.
Yeah.
Bible says don't go put no markings on your body.
Yes.
And sometimes we come to Christ and we have these things. That's under the blood.
Right.
And then people want to go out and get them and put them in the most craziest places. Why a woman won't get a tattoo on her cleavage?
Right.
Mm-hmm. Come on.
Amen.
That's a temptation.
Right.
And they feel tempted to get it because everybody else getting it.
Right.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Why somebody won't get a tattoo on their backside?
Right.
A tattoo on your buttocks. Why are you gonna go lay on the table? Drop your drawers. Lay up on the table. Let you pass gas.
That part.
thing to get that stuff before you get saved. See, I used to grow up thinking, oh, mom, get me an earring in my ear. I'm getting a tattoo. My mom, you see. And my mom's pretty lenient. She said, well, you go that far, you better find another place to live. Amen. You ain't living here.
Amen.
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 Tattoo. Yeah, tattoo. You don't need to be tempted to go get no tattoo. No.
Right.
Why?
Right.
Because everybody else got it. Because everybody else getting one. No. And it's the young generation that's feeling that pressure. I want to look like a superstar.
Yeah.
I give credit to where credit is due, but some of these superstars and athletes, hey man, they got them all over their body. All over chest, legs, thighs, face. Go try to get an interview. You ain't get no job.
That's right.
Yeah, yeah, properly. At the Starbucks. I mean, why? I want to get poked all over your face. Why? I just want something here. Why? You know how painful that is. I never got my ears pierced and don't plan on it. But then to get something put in your nose? Oh, you know, now it ain't the nose. Don't fall into that temptation. Get your tongue pierced. Come on now.
Right.
Amen. Because it's supposed to be some kind of ecstasy, I guess. I don't know why people do it. We giving in all kinds of temptation.
Right.
Where are we going to draw the line?
Yeah.
Where everybody else clicking on it? I might well watch it.
Uh-huh.
Don't you be tempted to go watch Little Demon.
No.
Amen.
Don't get tempted to go watch some of this stuff that the world say go watch.
Right.
But I come tell you, there's a way of escape.
Yeah.
It's through having the power of the Holy Ghost in your life.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. It's through having the power of God in your life.
That's right.
You can look the devil in the eye in every temptation. I'm not doing that.
That's right.
I'm not doing that.
That's right.
I'm not smoking that dope no more.
Yeah, that's right.
You looking at a living witness.
Yeah.
I smoked cocaine,
amen.
Snorted it, smoked it,
amen.
Drank all kind of liquor,
right.
Clubbed all night. God knows if I wouldn't say anything, boy, well, I'd be clubbing all over the place. Thank God I'm saved.
Amen.
Club, drinking, shacking up. But when I got saved,
amen.
And I got a mind to want to be saved. See, you got to have a mind to want to be saved when you're not at church. You got to have a mind and desire. We're going to overcome temptation. When I'm not at church, I'm going to be saved. When I go on this job, I'm going to be saved. When I go home and visit my family, I'm going to be saved. And if all they want to go and, hey, you want to, you know, they'll tell you, let's go out and let's go to the nail place. And, oh, what are we going to, oh, ain't nothing wrong, get your feet done. But when you get there, they want to do everything to your feet. And I'm not making fun of it. You don't want a little color? You want to make your feet a little pretty with a little color? Just make it pretty and clean it up. And leave it like it is. No color. You got a boyfriend? You put the little color, you get the boyfriend. That's what they say. My wife tell me that's what they say. You want a boyfriend? You don't have no boyfriend? No, I got a husband. You can get a boyfriend. You put a little color on your feet. If God wanted you to have color on your feet, who'd have made your feet colorful? God got enough sense. God got enough sense that if he wanted you to have blue eyes, he would have gave you blue eyes. If God wanted you to have red eyes, he would have gave you red eyes. If God wanted you to have purple feet, toenails, he would have gave you purple toenails.
Amen. Amen.
But we feel that temptation. We get up in there and they be like, oh, you want, you ain't got no backbone to say no. Stop right there. Just stop right. Stop right there. No backbone. But when you ain't got no backbone, you'll fall into any temptation.
Right.
You'll find a man and not even saved.
Yeah.
Give him that phone. Oh, yeah, here's my phone number, man. Mm. Call me.
Right.
When you don't have no backbone, you'll give in to any temptation.
That's right.
Any temptation. But what gives you backbone is the Holy Ghost.
Right.
I said the Holy Ghost will give you backbone.
That's right.
I'm not doing that. Let's all stand.
Jesus.
Try to give you some therapy today.
We got it.
You can't give in on these temptations. I'm not doing it. Because if you keep giving in these temptations, you're kind of be like this man, just trapped. Don't know where you're going, don't know what you're doing. But how many want to overcome the temptation? You know the struggle, the battle you're fighting right now. Why don't you lift your hand for a moment? Come on, just lift your hands for a moment. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, God, I come before you right now. God, I need you, Lord. I don't want to keep giving in, God, to the weaknesses of my flesh. God, what I want to do, when I want to do it, how I want to do it. I want to yield and give to you, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. Not my will, but your will be done. Hallelujah. If you're here today and you need the power of the Holy Ghost in your life to overcome certain temptations, it's trying to trap you, destroy you. And you know without the power of God in your life, you'll never overcome those temptations. But you see, I want the Spirit of God in my life. I want the Holy Ghost to help me overcome this temptation. There is a way of escape, and the way of escape is through having the Spirit of God, the power of God in your life. Come on, in the name of Jesus Christ.
Prison shake at the sound of Jesus' name. Lives made whole, hearts awake at the sound of Jesus' name.